Of course, recognition was absolutely essential to an institution of higher education because it affected your ability of students to transfer to college and universities. At least theoretically, if you weren't accredited, then students may have to take special exams or special courses in order to be admitted. So it's absolutely essential to get it. The North Central had a policy to immediately grant correspondent status. Just as soon as you're created, they gave you correspondent status, which was sort of like, a provisional. we'll give you the full accreditation if you behave yourself. So then immediately the task was to try to gain full accreditation. And you have to go through a process to do that. You have to involve a lot of people, faculty and counselors and the public, students, in order to do that. And ultimately that culminates in a written document, an North Central report. And then they start with your philosophy and then how you implement that philosophy. And they particularly are interested in how many books you have in the library and the qualifications of your faculty and your admission requirements and all of these things. The way we got the library was that there was some company that when all these community colleges were being formed, got the idea, they'd put together a package, a library package. So you could buy that package and it would have proper number of reference books, the proper. So we bought the package. So it's kind of a supermarket library package, Walmart, a Walmart library. So we bought that, and of course, just developing curriculum, hiring faculty, so on. So I think it was in about 1972 when we were granted full status. That was kind of coming of age, like in college. If we had been denied, then that would have affected our ability to recruit students, to recruit faculty.